Hey everybody, this is Hart back with you. I wanted to show off this time my Final Fight collection from the series, which thankfully does not include Final Fight Streetwise, that terrible 3D game from last gen. This right here is Capcom Classics Mini Mix for the GBA. It includes three NES games, one of them being my new Final Fight. I got to the end boss, I believe, and it's pretty cheap, so I didn't actually beat him, but it's pretty good anyway, and here's one of my more favorite ones, Final Fight 1 for the GBA. It's kind of a remake of the Super Nintendo game, I guess you could say, because it still has the guys in place of the girls in there, and it's pretty cool. It actually has the Cody and Guy from Street Fighter Alpha 3 in it. It's pretty good. This is the Classics collection of Remixed. It has the arcade game on it, so obviously that's the best version of the original game. And of course these are all the original Super Nintendo games here. The original GIMPed version of Final Fight, which I don't obviously recommend. But after that, they of course made it way better with Final Fight 2, which is what the first one should have been, as far as the selectable characters and whatnot. Actually, I think this one has four characters. Same with the next one, which is one I'm going to show you some gameplay footage of, Final Fight 3. Out of the three on the Super Nintendo, this is my favorite, because it just has so much cool stuff in it. And now we're going to get to the footage here of me playing through the first stage. As you can see, here's Guy, Dean, which is a newcomer, Lucia, also a newcomer, and Hagar. And I take him a lot because it's funny to be a crazy-ass, big-muscled mayor. What I like is this game actually has a lot of different a lot of different moves, which I like, and why I like Streets of Rage 2 so much, because earlier games in the Final Fight series kind of lacked all the crazy moves you could do with the minimal amount of buttons. Do your typical punch combo like that. You have that. If you get him from the back, you can actually do a different type of throw, which I do show. That's one that's on the ground, but you can also do one that's above, and here it is. Bam. I love that one. Especially if I move him side to side, I can get a lot of people with that one. It has a better range. And that's the super move, which is actually when the bar fills up at the bottom. When it changes over to super, you have a limited time before it empties on its own. And you can actually do a character special move. I think Guy has like a fireball type move. Or doesn't actually, it's kind of more of a Dan from Street Fighter Alpha series type move. It doesn't actually leave his hand, but it's still pretty cool because he actually leans forward, and it really helps. And also, one of the things I like is this, the clothesline. If you get it with a group of enemies, it actually hits multiple times, which is pretty cool. This game also makes it so, it does bring back like the Lariat. Hit the punch and jump buttons together, and you get the special move that takes away some of your life to clear enemies. It's still good, but this game gives you a lot more options, so you don't have to rely on it as much, so you can keep your life, which is good. I like that. Good old awesome beat-em-up action. Now, this game does have slowdown, because I just packed a whole bunch of shit in this game. But honestly, it doesn't really bother me, because some of the slowdown, I don't know. Seems to be really the only real problem I have with it, but it's a very minor problem. Overall, much more of a different experience than either the first game or the second game had, because the second game really was just what the first game, like I said, should have been. Sorry, get those barrels. And in here, so usually I don't like weapons in this series, because it's one hit and you gotta wait for them to get up and it doesn't take away much. But as you can see here, it actually is multiple hits just like your punches. And another move that Hagar has that's pretty cool is that right there. You don't have to have a weapon to do it, I just usually do in this clip. When he leans forward and follows through with a double axe, sweeping double axe handle, it's a really effective move there too. Extra life, yay! These are actually more of a supers or fairly Street Fighter style special move combinations. But they're not like terribly difficult. Now the way I've been always been pulling off that super spinning pile driver is actually doing a full circle, you know, like you would with if you use Zangief in Street Fighter, but I know it doesn't take that. I've looked it up, but I just don't remember it, so. And it's pretty reliable the way I've been doing it, so that's how I've been continuing to do it. So yeah, that's Final Fight 3. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.